set out on a great adventure the day my father started leading me home. And he said there's gonna be some mountains to climb and valleys we're gonna go through. But I had no way of knowing just how hard this journey could be, 'cause the valleys are deeper and the mountains are steeper than I would ever have dreamed. But I know we're gonna make it, and I know we're gonna get there soon, and I know sometimes it feels like we're going the wrong way. It's just a long way home. Got some rocks in my shoes, fears I wish I could lose, that make the mountain so hard to climb. And my heart gets so heavy with the weight of the world sometimes. There's a bag of regrets, my should-have-beens and not-yets, I keep on dragging around. And I can hardly wait for the day that I get to lay them all down. But I know the day is coming, and I know it's gonna be here soon, and I won't turn back even the whole world says I'm going the wrong way. It's just a long way home. When we can't take another step, the Father will pick us up and carry us in His arms. Even on the best days, He says to remember we're not home yet. So don't get too comfortable, 'cause we really are just pilgrims passing.
Good morning, friends, and welcome to Trinity United Church of Christ in Brookfield, Wisconsin. As you know, Pastor Susan is enjoying a much-needed vacation. So today, we are doing things a bit differently. Today, we are celebrating not only our music ministry, but that it is also Access Sunday. Access Sunday is a time we celebrate those with differing abilities and disabilities. We celebrate their gifts and their talents that they bring to our faith communities. Access Sunday is a reminder that we are all made in the image of God, and a reminder that in the United Church of Christ, that no matter who you are truly welcome here. So let us worship. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Come, all, for you are welcome in this sacred place. Let us worship God together.
I will lift the cloud of night before you. What is wrong, I'll make it right before you. All the battles I will fight before you, and the high places I'll bring down. When you walk towards the way, I'll lead you. On the produce of the land, I'll feed you. And a home within my heart, I need you. And the high places I'll bring down. With an everlasting love, I love you. Though the trials I will test and prove you, still there's nothing that I can or hurt you. And the high place I'll bring down. When you walk and lose the way, I lead you. On the produce of the land, I'll feed you. And a home within my heart, I'll lead you. And the high place I'll bring down. Although Satan in a rage will tear you, and with every winning heart will snare you, yet from youth to youth of hope to prepare you, and the high place I'll bring down. When you walk and lose the way, I'll lead you. On the produce of the land, I'll feed you. And a home within my heart, I'll lead you. And the high place I'll bring down. Cloud of night before you, I will make the crooked straight before you. I will spread my wings to roll, protect you, and the high place I'll bring down. When you walk and lose the way, I lead you. On the produce of the land, I'll feed you. And a home within my heart, I'll lead you. And the high place I'll bring down. And the high place I'll bring down. And the high place I'll bring down.
Would you please join me in our morning prayer? Our gracious and loving God, we have all been made in your image. We come together as a diverse group of people with differing abilities and talents. We sometimes are hesitant to share our talents, but we know that you recognize that we bring special gifts to your ministry. No matter what our abilities or talents are, we are still in need of you. We are all your children, and we are thankful for your love. With your guidance, we open our hearts for each other and for our community. We do so with compassion, understanding, and love. We praise you, and we are able through you. This is our prayer to you. Amen.
Today's Hebrew lesson is from Psalm 139, verses 13 and 14. For it was you who formed me, my inward parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works that I know very well.
There's a wall that has been standing since the day that I fell. Sin is where it started, sin is where it held. Speaking as a prisoner who was there and lived to tell, I remember how it fell. I can hear the sound of freedom like a distant voice that called and beckoned me to follow, and I had never gone. Though my heart was willing, I guess stood against the wall.
the doorway and a hand that held the key. When the chains fell on my feet for the first time I could see. This is how it feels to be free. This is what it means to know that I am forgiven. This is how it feels to be free. To see that life can be more than I imagine. This is how it feels to be free, yeah. This is how it feels to be free, yeah.
There are days when I'm reminded of the prison I was in, living in a nightmare, burning deep within. I can feel the voice of evil, I can hear the call of sin, but I won't go back again. Once I tasted freedom, and the chains goodbye no more, mercy gave me wings to fly like an eagle I could soar. This is how it feels to be free. This is what it means to know that I am forgiven. This is how it feels to be free. To see that life can be more than I imagine. This is how it feels to be free, yeah. This is how it feels.
Our gospel lesson from this morning comes from the Gospel of John, chapter 9, verses 1 through 3. A man born blind receives sight. As he walked along, he saw a man blind from birth. His disciples asked him, "Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind?" Jesus answered, "Neither this man nor his parents sinned. He is born blind so that God's work might be revealed in him." Open minds, open hearts, the sacred word of God. Thanks be to God.
misery.
Good morning, kids. Today, Michaela and I are going to read you a special poem. Michaela?
I'm special. In all the world, there is nobody like me.
Since the beginning of time, there has never been another person like me. Nobody has my smile. Nobody has my eyes, my nose, my hair, my hands, my voice. God made me special.
In all time, there has been no one who laughs like me, no one who cries like me, and what makes me laugh and cry will never provoke identical laughter and tears from anybody else, ever.
I'm the only one in all of God's creation who has my set of abilities. Oh, there will always be somebody who is better at one of the things I'm good at. But no one in the universe can reach the quality of my combination of talents, ideas, and feelings.
Through all eternity, no one will ever look, talk, walk, think, or act like me. I'm special, I'm rare, and I'm precious.
And as in all rarity, there is great value. Because of my great, rare value, I need not attempt to imitate others. I will accept, yes, celebrate, my differences and my limitations.
I'm special, and I'm beginning to realize it's no accident that I'm special. I'm beginning to see that God made me special for a very special purpose. He must have a job for me that no one else can do so well as I.
That's right, kids. You are special, and you add so much to our faith family. So remember, you're made in God's image, and God loves you. Bye. Join me in a version of the Lord's Prayer that we have used in the UCC's Disabilities Ministries Board. It is an inclusive prayer and is from the New Zealand Prayer Book. Eternal Spirit, Earth Maker, Pain Bearer, Life Giver, Source of all that is and that shall be, Father and Mother of us all, loving God and whom is in heaven, the hallowing of your name echo through the universe. The way of your justice be followed by the peoples of the world. Your heavenly will be done by all created beings. Your commonwealth of peace and freedom. Sustain our hope and come on earth. With the bread we need for today, feed us. In the hurts we absorb from one another, forgive us. In times of temptation and testing, strengthen us. From trials too great to endure, spare us. From the grip of all that is evil, free us. For your reign in the glory of the power that is love, now and forever. Amen. Though our outdoor part two worships are over, we still will be having events in the month of October. We have two events that are coming up this month that we just want to let you know about. First, a young man named Bryce with Troop 21, who is working on his Eagle Scout project, will be running a pet food supply drive on Sunday, October 18th from 10 a.m. to noon. All donations will go to the Elmbrook Humane Society. Please see your MailChimps and the website for more information. The second thing that we're doing this October is we are going to be having our second annual Trunk or Treat on Saturday, October 24th from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. in the South parking lot. Masks and social distancing will be required. If there are any questions, please contact Don Falk for further information. Thank you. As always, Thank you for continuing to share your gifts in this unprecedented time. We are extremely blessed for each and every one of you and your gifts and talents that you bring to Trinity each and every day. We are grateful. Now please join me in the prayer of dedication of these gifts and talents. We thank you, O Holy One, for your guidance and protection during these days. We give thanks for the gifts you have planted within us and commit ourselves to use our gifts to make a difference, to bring abundant life and love to the world you so love. Let our offerings be blessings to others. Amen.
Two fishermen who lived along the Sea of Galilee stood by the shore to cast their nets into an ageless sea. Now Jesus watched from them afar, then called them each by name. It changed their lives, these simple men, they never be the shame. Lead all things you have and come and follow me. And come and follow me. And as he walked along the shore, 'twas James and John he'd find, and these two sons of Zebedee would leave their boats behind. Their work and all they held so dear, they left beside their nets. Their names they heard as Jesus called, they came without regret. Leave all things you have and come and follow me, and come and follow me. And Simon, Peter, Andrew, James, and John, beloved one, you heard Christ's call to speak good news revealed to God's own Son. Hosanna, Mary Magdalene, who traveled with the Lord, you ministered to him with joy, from he is God adored. Leave all things you have and come and follow me, and come and follow me. And you good Christians, one and all, who follow Jesus' ways, come leave behind what keeps you bound to trappings of our day. Listen as he calls your name to come and follow near, for still he speaks in varied ways to call and his will near. Leave all things you have and come and follow me. Leave all things you have and come and follow me.
And now, a benediction. We are one, yet we are many. We are all made in the image of God, and God's love has been imparted on us to share. Go out into the world and share the love and compassion that has been imbued upon us. We represent a just world for all. Go in peace, my friends. Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. There is a name that makes evil shudder. Blessed be the name of the Lord. There is a name far above all others. Blessed be the name of the Lord. There is a name that will heal all nations. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Your name, your name, Jesus, your name will endure. Blessed be the name of the Lord. There is a name that above salvation. Blessed be the name of the Lord. There is a name that will heal the nation.
the Lord. Your name. Your name will endure. Your name. Blessed be the name.